Hello and welcome back to Proactive New York. I'm Christine Corrado. With me on Skype today is Matt Callahan, CEO of Botanix Pharmaceuticals. Matt, great to see you.
Great to see you too. Thanks for having me.
Matt, Botanix is an Australian listed company specializing in the CBD space. Just tell me a bit more about the company to start off with.
Yeah, so we're a pharmaceutical company focused on using CBD for a range of serious skin diseases. So there's a lot of interest in the molecule, obviously, at the moment with its antimicrobial and its anti-inflammatory effects. And we're really leveraging those across a range of different skin diseases like acne and atopic dermatitis.
Well, CBD products are gaining a lot of traction here in the US. Can you kind of walk me through your R&D pipeline at the moment?
Sure. So we're taking an FDA approval route with these products. So we're looking to have these products in the hands of dermatologists and physicians to be prescribed just like any other prescription medicine. So to do that, we're doing clinical studies. We're most advanced in moderate to severe acne at the moment. And we also have a phase two study underway in atopic dermatitis or severe eczema. We have some other clinical programs that are coming along behind that in psoriasis and in some antimicrobial applications. But our goal is obviously to take these all the way through to FDA approval and then ultimately to commercialization, either by ourselves as a company or with a partner.
Well, yeah, it seems like the company is increasing its exposure to the US market. Can you tell me a bit about today's announcement and the company's capital raise today?
Sure. So we've obviously been increasing our US presence with some recent hires, but today's announcement was that we'd raised $40 million from mostly US biotech life sciences institutions who've invested into the Australian ASX-listed company. And for us, it's a real validation at the stage that we're at in our clinical program of both the interest in CBD as a molecule, but also the success that we've had so far with our clinical programs and the clinical data that we're generating, the treatment effect for CBD in both acne and dermatitis.
Yeah, just more specifically, how will these funds kind of support the company's R&D goals in the future?
So at the moment, we're fully funded to complete our phase two studies, but this new cash enables us to accelerate those programs by doing some of the clinical and preclinical work that we otherwise have to do before these programs can go into phase three. It's also going to be used to bring into the clinic our first application of CBD as a standalone antimicrobial. It's very exciting, the application for CBD as a new form of antibiotic, particularly given that many of the resistant bacteria that we have today don't form resistance to CBD, and it kills so quickly across a range of those common bacteria that we see in the clinic and now also in the community.
Yeah, this seems like it has the potential to affect people's lives. I mean, can you kind of expand upon that?
Yes, I mean, it's an amazing molecule. It's one of the only molecules we've studied where the safety profile of the drug is so good that you don't really have dose limitations. As you give more drug to the patient, you don't see significantly more side effects or really any serious side effects in the studies that we've done. The product itself, CBD, is very antimicrobial. It's also anti-inflammatory in the studies that we've done in the skin. And that really is the basis for most skin diseases that we have around today. So within one drug, we've really got two separate effects. And that's really powerful for the treatment of moderate to severe skin diseases, as well as a standalone antimicrobial opportunity. So finding drugs that don't cause more problems than they solve is kind of the goal of the pharmaceutical industry. And this is a really good target for that.
Just circling back to something that you said earlier in the interview, in addition to the capital raise, you've also recruited some new executive team members. Who are these team members and why have you recruited them?
Yeah, so we've been able to announce the recruitment of Chief Commercial Officer, Howie McKibben. Howie comes to us with a great background in dermatology with companies like Medicis and Anacor that both have transacted very successfully in the US market, as well as Rick Peterson. So Rick's coming on board as our Chief Financial Officer and ultimately Company Secretary. He's got about 25, 30 years in pharmaceuticals, specifically in dermatology with Medicis, and he's been involved in a number of the recent dermatology IPOs as well. So very experienced team to kind of make that leap, I think, you know, to professionalize the team in the US with commercialization experience and really take the company to the next level.
To the next level, indeed. Matt Callahan, really appreciated learning more. Thanks so much.
Thanks so much.